Hello, everyone, and thank you for joining us for another episode of Certified, Certiport's Educator Podcast. I'm your host, Hannah Crapeau. Join us as we dive into the world of education, certification, and technology. Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of Certified, Certiport's Educator Podcast. We're so happy to have you back listening with us. We're here today with a special guest from Microsoft, Jeff Johnson from the education team. Jeff, thank you so much for being here with us.
Thank you, Hannah.
We're happy to have you back. And for those who maybe haven't listened to the previous episode that we had with you last year, I wanted to give you a chance to introduce yourself and tell us about your role at Microsoft.
Yeah, appreciate that. Hi, everyone. I am Jeff Johnson. I am the global lead for our employability and skills programs at Microsoft, looking after outreach with both K-12 education and higher education institutions globally. And so in that role, I have the unique opportunity to meet with educators and school leaders and ministries of education around the next wave of technology and how that can help impact and improve the learning outcomes for students globally, and importantly, the work that we do around certifications and credentials that students can earn and the skills learning that will help them in the workforce ahead.
Well, I'm very excited to be able to tie in those new technologies that you mentioned and talk about this wonderful event that Microsoft is hosting, Imagine Cup Junior. So for those who aren't familiar with Imagine Cup Junior, can you give us a little bit of an intro?
Yeah, sure. Happy to do that. And it's actually a great pleasure and a fantastic part of our role here at Microsoft is, speaking of new technologies, is to really focus on AI or artificial intelligence educational opportunities for students. And this is a really key way that we do that is our Imagine Cup Junior competition. This is an annual competition, Hannah and everyone, that is in its fifth year with Microsoft. Now, many of you may know of our long-held, more than 20 years, we've had the Microsoft Imagine Cup competition, a technology competition focused on students and learners who are 18 years and older, so typically in higher education or vocational education beyond. This Imagine Cup Junior is a fantastic competition that we've focused on students at younger ages, including ages 5 to 18 years of age. And the concept and the idea is that students will form teams and they'll be able to focus on the latest AI technologies to help dream up solutions to solve some of the world's biggest challenges. And it's a fantastic program and competition opportunity for students all around the world.
And you mentioned that it's starting now with students 5 to 18, and I know that that's kind of a change for this year. So what's different about this year's Imagine Cup Junior as opposed to last year and previous years?
Yeah, I'm glad you caught that. And I intentionally gave a little inflection there on the 5 to 18 because we added this year an additional age group because in part due to the great demand we have seen from educators and from school leaders around how can Microsoft help add some AI educational opportunities into the schools and the school systems for K-12 educators and most importantly for students. And so based on the growth of this program, and by the way, we've seen, you know, thousands and thousands of teams entering now at the 13 to 18 year old. One of the big changes this year is we've added 5 to 12 year olds as a competition category, if you will, and really expanding the impact and expanding the reach of the Imagine Cup Junior program. You talked a little bit, Hannah, about other changes or just changes in general this year. So one of them, a key one, obviously, is that age range I talked about. Another key element, and people will know this, that one of the key principles of the program is not just a competition. We think that's valuable for students in and of itself, but we also believe it's very valuable to provide curriculum and content that teachers and educators can use in the classroom with their students so that they can learn the principles of AI. They can learn about responsible and ethical principles around AI. And importantly, this year, another change is we added a whole section and curriculum modules on generative AI. So folks have known in the past, we've had some modules around traditional or standard AI, if you will. Now we're adding generative AI information so students can learn about, you know, kind of new burgeoning careers that are even coming out around prompt engineering, or how do I do prompt imaging with some of the Microsoft tools. Now, we're not expecting students at those ages to, you know, have to know coding or know in depth the technology aspects, but we want to start to give them the concept around AI and how AI can make a difference in their lives. So that's another key change, is we added the generative AI this year. And then I'd be remiss if I didn't call out another big change this year, is we added some additional language content localization. So we've added language supports for Arabic and for French and Spanish and for Japanese, so that we can ideally, all of these, I think you're getting a theme here, is to actually increase our reach and increase the impact and reach with more and more students around the world.
Well, it sounds like, and this is no surprise to me, but obviously this is a really important initiative for Microsoft, and you guys have dedicated a lot of time and resources to be able to make this something that's accessible to students around the world. Why, for Microsoft, is it important for educators and students to really dive into the world of artificial intelligence?
Yeah, I think that's a great question. And it actually resonates around the value of the volumes of data that's all around us. And I think also the fact that artificial intelligence in many ways is all around us, from computer visioning, and we're seeing more and more chatbots and even companies that are embracing AI technologies. And so we see this as a world that's obviously changing around students with more and more advanced technologies for AI that is in the work. It's coming into the workplace, and we're getting this from requests from our businesses and customers that we work with every day. And we're seeing this as an opportunity that we want to make sure students, when they're in their educational or formal educational years, I'll say, are having that opportunity to learn more about the principles of AI and how they can work on whether it's imaging or visioning that will be and actually sift through the volumes of data and understand about machine learning, et cetera, that's coming so prevalent in the workplace, but that we want students to understand some of those principles so that when they get ready to go for more advanced learning or more advanced training, or ultimately go into the workforce, that they'll be that much better prepared for some of these new AI models that are coming into the workplace. So we see that as kind of a key piece of this from a Microsoft perspective. And I think it fits in our vision and our mission of empowering every learner to achieve more around the planet. And also it fits our vision around that this is really about lifelong learning. You heard me talk about a focus I have around K-12 education and our teams here at Microsoft focusing as well on higher education. But really, in many ways, this is about lifelong learning. And we often use the expression K to career. That may resonate for some in the audience today, talking about students learning as young as, you know, 4, 5, 6 years old, starting to at least touch or learn about technologies. And that they're going to continue to evolve that learning as they go through life and in and on into their career. So I just think AI is everywhere around us now. Yeah. It's in the news. It's part of CEO discussions with employees and with Wall Street and everywhere else around the world. So I just think there's a great opportunity here for students to learn more while they're in their formal schooling years.
I couldn't agree more. I think that that's a hot topic for a lot of educators right now, is how can we leverage the tools effectively in the classroom? How can I help my students understand the principles behind artificial intelligence? And so a competition like this is a really great opportunity to kind of weave that in fairly naturally. So we've talked a little bit about this already, but who can participate in this competition? Then we're looking at age demographic of 5 to 18. What are the other stipulations in place around who can enter?
Yeah, it's a great question, and we value the educational system, so we include any school entity around the globe. It's any country, students, educators can participate. The key is to form a team within the classroom or within the school, et cetera, or multiple teams within a school. Our standard teams are between two and six students, or two and six individuals, at the 13 to 18 year old range. The 5 to 12 year old, that can be a little different. That could be a whole class experience around that. But when it comes to the 13 to 18 year old, we look for a team to form, or teams, multiple teams. Many schools offer multiple teams. It becomes part of a class activity or part of their program of study at the school. And then there should be a teacher or an adult guardian over 18 years of age who will serve as the mentor and the coach for the team, and will really help, help with the learning around AI principles. They'll also be the person who the adult or teacher will be the one who can download the lessons, deliver the lesson plans, et cetera, for the students to take advantage of. And they'll be the one who uploads the ultimate competition artifact for the students when they officially enter the competition with their entry. So really, it's wide open. It could be a public school. It can be a private school. But most importantly, form a team with that, and then have an adult leader, ideally a teacher or a parent or guardian, who can serve as the mentor and coach for the team. We've seen such tremendous interest in this program all over the world. It's amazing how many countries. I think more than 100 countries last year in the program. We saw thousands more competitors or competitive teams enter. And in fact, Hannah and other, we had entire countries that embraced the program from their ministries of education and made it a competition within the country as well. So they, in many ways, those in the Certiport audience know the MOS competition, the Microsoft Office Specialist competition. This has some great tenets that are in many ways similar to that, where you see great local and regional competitions that spur up around that MOS competition. And similarly, we're seeing that same energy, that same enthusiasm from school teams and from teachers around this Imagine Cup Junior. So in fact, I got to make a plug here for that MOS competition. If folks haven't taken a look at that one, make sure you do, because if your students love the Imagine Cup Junior, they'll really get a boost out of participating in that MOS competition as well. And that's available for anyone, any student who wants to excel. But I think they're 13 to 22 year olds who go after a test in Office around either Word or PowerPoint or Excel. And that could be a great complimentary experience for students who've had a great time with Imagine Cup Junior. What I would do next, that could be one of them, is the MOS competition as well.
Love that crossover. And I think the same type of demographic would be really excited about both of those, to your point. And I think educators who are listening are really excited about the resources that you've mentioned, that Microsoft has taken so much time to develop curriculum and different lesson plans and things like that to make AI more approachable. So I wanted to ask, where are those resources, or what can educators leverage to prepare their students to enter the competition?
Yeah, it's a great point. We've invested considerably in building out what we could call the official curriculum for the Imagine Cup Junior. And it's a modularized curriculum, and it's built out in lesson plans that teachers can pace across various weeks as they get their students ready to form their teams and build their competitive entries. And so that material is all available through the Microsoft website on Microsoft.com, WAC Imagine Cup Junior. And anybody can even do a Bing search, and you'll be able to find that on Imagine Cup Junior and find our access to our content elements. And again, it's any educator or school leader can be downloading those and make those available. And I should mention another great resource are the hackathons that we do. And those are open to all, and we welcome folks. Again, those are also available. The dates are on the webpage and links to information about our hackathons. But we bring teams. By the time a team has formed, they get this great opportunity to come in and they can learn more, or educators can come in and learn more about the whole program and the project through hackathons. And those are actually going to be held in the months of March and April in 2024 here, ahead of the competition final little later in the year.
So I know that there's probably a lot of people who are really excited about the possibility of having their students enter. but maybe thinking, I don't know a ton about AI. I don't know how to teach my students necessarily how to code or create a project within AI. So I wanted to ease some of that nervousness maybe a little bit and talk about the project requirements. What are the students uploading and creating as part of Imagine Cup Junior?
Yeah, that's a great point. So the students do not have to be coders. They do not have to be deep in technology. We're not expecting that by any means. But what we are expecting is that they work well in a team, that they build their concept, and then that they're able to communicate the elements of their concept for around AI very effectively to the judges. And so the judges will be looking for things like originality. Was there a consideration around the security of the project or the concept? Were there considerations around the scalability of the concept? Were there considerations around the accessibility of the concept? So there's a whole rubric that our judges will look at, and that's available to the adult leaders as well, to be able to say to their students, okay, but have you thought about this part of your project? Have you thought about this part of your concept? And when students come up with concepts, they have just no limits, the dreams and the visions that they can come up with. It can be a challenge or an issue that they're seeing locally, or many of our students are addressing very large global challenges like environmental sustainability or food waste management has been a theme, one of the winners last year. Others have delved into issues around healthcare, hearing loss, reading accessibility for readers who need assistance. And the range of challenges and vision that students have, there is no there's no boundary setting to that. It's really whatever students can dream up and might think that AI or AI concept or some of the newer technology tools, even their what APIs they can come up with, could address the challenge is really a welcome a landscape for students to enter in this competition.
I love that it really connects the students to real world problems, right? It really mm-hmm. helps them see the power of AI technology. And I wanted to ask, of course, once you get this kind of fire going, it's hard to see the momentum kind of die away when there's nothing as follow-up, right? So for our educators who are listening, how can they keep the excitement going in their classroom around the world of artificial intelligence?
Yeah, it's a great point. I can't agree more. This shouldn't be just a one and done. I would love to have everyone get started with through Imagine Cup Junior as a way to introduce AI. But we know that I would say I'm going to take this both two ways. One is the educators themselves, and we Microsoft have recently put on our learning platform, our flagship learning platform, which by the way is called Microsoft Learn. We've put some new coursework for educators who want themselves to continue to grow around AI education. And so we've got a new course series that's around just introducing AI and AI concepts for educators who want to feel more comfortable with that. And then we've added now a generative AI coursework as well for educators, all freely available on Microsoft Learn. So that's for sure one element is for the teachers and the educators themselves who'd like to skill up around AI. And then the other, and then I think this is what you're really gearing toward, is what about students? What might they think of as next? And so really we've working with our partners internally in the company and working with our Certiport partner, we've built a set of certification courses as well that helps students to be able to go even deeper around our AI technologies. And we call it our fundamentals series of exams. And we have a very specific exam called AI fundamentals. Some of you might know the number, the exam number is called AI 900, but don't let the 900 scare anyone. That is truly our foundational course and foundational exam. And the coursework, again, is also out there available on the Microsoft Learn platform. And then there may be other venues as well. And I know Certiport has practice exams for that that exam as well. So a teacher could incorporate the curricula and a practice exam and then prepare students to earn an industry-recognized, globally recognized certificate as part of their schoolwork. And by the way, some schools have started now to provide credits, so academic credit, to students when they earn that certification. Or some schools use it as extra credit, or it can be a part of the grade. So there's lots of different flexible alternatives or options around those certification additives. But the important point, and kind of trying to answer your question, is yes, you can treat the Imagine Cup Junior as a starting place. And then between Certiport and Microsoft, we've built these additional curriculas and certifications around AI fundamentals to help students really get that next step as they move closer and closer toward either further education or going on into the workforce with these new skills that they've learned.
I love that this is just kind of the starting point, right? Of Absolutely. Students really getting excited about artificial intelligence and educators as well. Because to your point, Jeff, this is something that we're seeing in the news all the time and we're now interacting with almost constantly. So the idea that it's approachable for people, it's a way for people to kind of get exposed to that world and then, you know, just a starting point to be able to launch from there. So thank you to you and the team at Microsoft for putting this amazing competition together. We hope that a lot of people who are listening are able to form a team and enter their students, and we'll have links to all of those resources that Jeff mentioned in the show notes for this episode as well. So thank you so much, Jeff, for walking us through it, getting us excited. We're excited to see where we land with all of these entries in the next couple of months.
Absolutely. And thank you, Hannah, and thanks to the Certiport team. And importantly, thanks to all of our audience of educators and school leaders today. And we'd love to hear your great success stories around Imagine Cup Junior. And we wish all of your competing teams very well in Imagine Cup Junior 2024.
Thank you. Thanks for listening to another episode of our podcast. We're so happy to have you as part of our certified community. Make sure to follow and rate our podcast so that we can bring more educators into our wonderful and supportive group. We're also here to connect, so feel free to join us by visiting www.certified.certiport.com.